In this week's video, we're looking at gout. We're gonna look at how to get rid of it, and most importantly, we're gonna look at how to prevent it. So what are we waiting for? Let's do this. Okay, so first let's begin with the science. And I know what you're thinking, a lot of you are probably thinking, let's just get straight to those tips. Let's get straight to how to treat it. But it's really important that you first understand why we get gout, because all of this is gonna help for when we're talking about treatments and when we're talking about preventative tips. So it's super important that you listen to this bit, but if you already know all about gout and the science behind it, then I'm gonna leave a timestamp here or here, and also in the description below that you can click to go straight to the treatment tips and the preventative tips. So first of all, what is gout? Gout is a type of inflammatory arthritis where we get pain and swelling in our joints, like our fingers, like our toes. Sometimes when we get gout, it can also be red and hot to touch on that area. Now, gout comes on suddenly, and when it does come on suddenly, we call this a flare-up, or we call it a bout of gout, or we call it a gout attack. They all mean the same thing because it's a sudden flare-up. So the next question is, what actually causes the gout? Well, uric acid is one of the main causes. So when we eat foods such as meat and tuna, our body breaks them down into purines. These purines are then broken down into uric acid. And then unfortunately, the uric acid forms crystallizes in our joints. So this uric acid can damage our joints, and it can even cause kidney stones. So it can cause a few different problems. Now, gout is more likely in women. It's also more likely to happen to you as you get older. There is also a genetic link. So if someone in your family has gout, you're probably more likely to get it in the future. However, please remember, actually, let me fix this. That's better. Please remember that gout isn't something that you can really diagnose yourself. Please make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional first so they can actually diagnose gout for you. Because many different things and many different conditions have similar symptoms to gout. For example, you might actually have an infection that looks very similar to gout, which will need examining and testing. So it's super important that if you think you might have gout, make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional so they can do the examinations and they can do the tests to find out exactly what is wrong. Okay, so we're now getting to the fun bits. You've been to your healthcare professional, you've got gout, so what can you do? So the first thing that I always recommend to patients is ride it out. And by ride it out, I don't mean drive a car. Remember the words ride. R, rest. I, ice. D, for drink water. And E is elevate. Now we're gonna walk up these steps for each scene with a different tip. Now, before we go through each tip and up the steps, I thought I'd explain ride it out slightly more because I feel like I didn't give much information. So rest is pretty normal. Everyone knows what rest is. Ice, get an ice pack, get a pack of frozen peas, whatever you have, wrap it in a tea towel, place it on the area for about 5 minutes. Next up, we have drink water, and that's gonna help flush the uric acid out. And lastly, we have elevate. So you wanna keep the area elevated to increase the blood flow going through that area to stop the uric acid from accumulating in that one area. Okay, moving on to tip number two, and I hope this isn't too shaky. Adults can use ibuprofen, and it's gonna help with the swelling in the area and the pain. It's gonna help with all of that. So ibuprofen is fine to use for the gout, but please remember, always speak to your healthcare professional first to make sure that you're safe and suitable to take that medication, because ibuprofen can interact with many different people's medications. It can cause many different side effects. So make sure that you speak to your healthcare professional first before you take it. That is the most important thing, and always read the information leaflet that comes with it. Okay, moving on to tip number three. If you're still suffering from pain and any swelling, remember, visit your healthcare professional. Make an appointment to speak to them, because there are various different prescription-only medication available which help with gout, such as steroids, such as anti-gout tablets and gout preventative tablets. There's loads of different options, so make sure to make an appointment. Now, tip number four relates slightly to tip number three that we spoke about, but if gout is constantly bothering you and you're getting it multiple times in a year, please do make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional. Like I said earlier, there are medicines available that prevent you from getting gout, which are uric acid lowering tablets. They're available, and if it's bothering you and causing you trouble, please make an appointment to speak to them, because like I said earlier, there's various different treatment options available that will suit you. Okay, so we're done with treatments. You're now a pro at treating gout, but next up we have preventative tips, probably the most important part of this video, because self-care can have a massive impact. So please do listen up. Okay, so you're more likely to suffer from gout if you have uncontrolled high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, heart failure, poor renal functions, a poor kidney function. Now, I do have quite a few videos on, for example, blood pressure, cholesterol, diabetes, and I'll link them in the description below, but these conditions need to be fully controlled if you have them. So speak to your healthcare professional and make sure they are fully controlled, and make sure they're routinely being investigated and checked up on to make sure that they're fully controlled, and this is going to reduce your risk of gout. Okay, so next up, are you overweight? Because if you're overweight, it can increase your risk of gout. Now, the best way to check this is checking something called BMI, which I will leave a link to in the description below. If you are interested in losing weight, I do have quite a video on how to lose weight done from a study in Oxford, and it's really, really good, and it's helped loads of people. So if you haven't seen it, I will leave a link to it up here and in the description below. But also, apart from that, eating a healthy balanced diet and eating foods which aren't high in fats, all of these again can help prevent gout. There are certain foods which are high in purines as well, such as red meat, such as tuna, so eating these sparingly can help to reduce your risk of having a gout attack. Now I'm going to leave a full list, well, I'm going to leave a link to it in the description below of all the different foods and their purine amounts. It's a really useful article and I'd highly recommend everyone reads it if gout is something that you suffer from. Okay guys, it's time to debunk some myths, and it's time to have a coffee too because I am very thirsty. I'm quite tired now. First of all, eating cherries. Now, it's said that it reduces uric acid levels, but there just isn't enough evidence to prove that it actually does this and it helps with gout. Next up, do you take diuretics, otherwise known as water tablets? If you're not sure, speak to your pharmacist and check with them. Diuretics can increase our chances of getting gout. So if you are taking a diuretic and you're getting gout flare-ups all the time, this could be a cause. But please remember, do not stop any prescribed medication without consulting your healthcare professional first. This is just a little trigger point that I want you to think of, and if you do take a diuretic and you're having loads of gout flare-ups, speak to your healthcare professional about it. Also, please consider cutting back on alcoholic beverages and certain fruit juices. All of these can make gout worse and make you more prone to having a flare-up. So instead, try and drink water. It's healthy, it's low in calories, and it doesn't cause gout. Smoking can also make gout worse. So if you do smoke and you haven't quit yet, then you have to quit. And if you haven't seen my How to Quit Smoking video yet, what are you waiting for? Head over to it right now and get those tips and quit smoking today. And last but not least, maintain good joint health. You can do this quite easily by regularly doing low impact exercises such as walking and such as swimming. There's loads of different things that you can do, so I will leave a full list in the description below. Give it a read, see which ones that you can incorporate into your lifestyles. That, my friend, is the end of this week's video. You are now a gout pro. You now know all about treatments, you know about prevention, you know about the myths, you know about everything. So tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, tell everyone, because you're a gout pro. So I really hope you find this information helpful. Leave a comment below, let us know how you get on. And if you have any of your own tips, leave a comment too, because I'd love to read it, and I'm sure everyone watching this video would too. That's the end of this week's video. Always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Woo! Oh yeah, baby. I'll see you all next week with my coffee. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.